Hello everyone, I'm Razi Raif. I'm a Senior Program Manager with Azure Active Directory Engineering Team. Today, I'm going to talk about configuring custom domains for Azure Active Directory B2C using Azure Front Door. Let's take a look into some of the common use cases for custom domain in Azure AD B2C. The most common ask is the consistent branding when customers are working with Azure AD B2C and the default experience resolve into b2clogin.com. domain, as you can see that woodgroove.b2clogin.com. Now, this particular experience is less than ideal. A customer wanted to have their own branding. For example, on the right-hand side, you can see account.woodgroovedemo.com and identity.woodgroovedemo.com, two custom domains being onboarded, and better branding is achieved through those custom domains. Another common requirement for custom domain is when customer have multiple domain requirement to begin with, and this may be because they have sub companies or they have some sort of like a organization structure where the domains or having a subdomain is a critical need. Custom domains on Azure AD B2C are enabled through Azure Front Door. Azure Front Door is a global scalable entry point that uses Microsoft Global Edge Network to create fast, secure, and highly scalable web applications. It also have a built-in capability to streamline certificate management. And you can add, remove custom domains in a self-service fashion using either the portal, CLI, or ARM template, which provide infrastructure as a core capability. When it comes to certificate management, you have ability to bring your own certificate and get alerted when the certificate is about to expire. And basically going to allow you to save the certificate in Azure Key Vault. You can also choose Azure Front Door Provision Certificate, which require you to do no extra work, and it will automatically do the provisioning and rotation when the expiry happens. Finally, please keep in mind that Azure Front Door is an independent service. It basically licensed and built separately from Azure AD B2C. Let's take a look into a request response cycle from an architecture standpoint without using a custom domain. User will send a request through a browser to Azure AD B2C endpoint, in this case, controls.b2clogin.com. Browser will go ahead and perform what is known as DNS resolution or lookup, which is basically a mechanism through which you get the IP address against a domain. Now, once browsers get access to the IP address, it will actually perform a request. In this particular case, it's a GET request to this particular host address, and then it will send a certain headers, possibly some cookies. In response, Azure AD B2C will send HTML, CSS, and other artifacts along with header and cookies. So that is a high-level request and response without a custom domain. Let's take a look into a request response cycle with custom domain enabled through Azure Front Door. User, send a request to Azure AD B2C endpoint, which is enabled for custom domain, login.contoso.com. Browser will make a DNS resolution or lookup to get the IP address against this particular domain. The IP address points to Azure Front Door. So browser will send a request to Azure Front Door, which is going to take the request and forward it to Azure AD B2C. Azure AD B2C will process the request and send the response back to Azure Front Door, which is going to send the response back to the browser. Let's take a look at the sequence of steps needed to configure custom domain. You start by adding custom domain on Azure AD B2C tenant and verifying it. The next step is basically to create an Azure Front Door instance. You can create a new instance, which is recommended, but you can also repurpose an existing instance. Then you're going to add a front door host. You will add a backend pool, which is going to contain a backend pointing to Azure AD B2C. Then you're going to add a routing rule, which is going to forward the request from the front end host to the backend. You're going to configure the actual custom domain. This will require verification of the domain and also doing TLS or certificate deployment. And finally, you're going to do an update of the routing rule to make sure that your newly added custom domain can receive traffic. In this demo, I will show you how to configure custom domain on Azure AD B2C using Azure Front Door. I'm going to start by adding and verifying custom domain on Azure AD B2C tenant. In order for me to do that, I've already logged into my Azure AD B2C tenant, and I'm going to go to Azure Active Directory and select custom domain names option. Now, I will go ahead and select add custom domain and type in the custom domain that I wanted to add and verify. I will click add domain, and you can see it basically giving me two options to verify that I own this particular domain. Now I can use TXT or MX record. I will use TXT. I will copy this value, and I need to go to my domain registration and need to make a TXT record entry. This will be the next step. I'm going to go ahead and make a TXT record for my domain. And now I will go back into the Azure AD B2C tenant and verify the domain. Back into the Azure AD B2C tenant, I'm going to go ahead and click verify. And notice that this particular domain is now verified. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to the listings and notice that my account.northandmoors.com showing the status of verified. With the custom domain verified, we'll go ahead and now create an instance of Azure Front Door and perform the necessary steps for onboarding custom domains over there. We're going to create a new Azure Front Door instance. To do that, we're going to create a new resource and select Front Door in the search bar, and it will give us an option to create the Front Door instance. I will go ahead and select create. I will create a new resource group. Select the location. I will keep it as East US. Select NAS configuration. In this step, I will go ahead and set up the Front Door host. To add a Front Door host, I will select the plus option and then give it a host name. The host name is available. I will keep the other settings to default and select add. Next, I will set up the backend pool. To add a backend pool with a backend, I will select the plus sign and then I will give it a name and then select add a backend. Here, I need to select the host type. You will select custom host and then type in the B2C login endpoint for your tenant. I will disable the help probe and keep the default and select add. In the next step, I will add a routing rule. To add a routing rule, I will go ahead and select this plus option against the routing rules. Give a routing rule a name. I will keep all the defaults and I will select add. At this point, the basic configuration is complete. So I will go ahead and select review plus create. It will go ahead and perform the basic validation of the settings, and I will go ahead and finally create the instance. Now at this point, it will take a few moments, so I will come back to this deployment once it's finished. Deployment is completed successfully, so I'm going to go and select go to resource. This will take me to my Azure Front Door instance. I will go ahead and select Front Door Designer from the left settings pane. Now here you can see that all the configuration that we performed earlier is available to us. We'll go ahead and perform the onboarding of custom domain. In order for us to do that, I will go ahead and select frontend/domains option. Here I will provide the custom domain that I wanted to onboard. I'm going to go ahead and type in the custom domain that I wanted to add. And at this point, it basically asking me to create a canonical name or CNAME in short. A record which basically going to point my custom domain to Azure Front Door instance. Now this particular configuration need to take place in the DNS provider. So I will go to my DNS provider and make this CNAME change. Now I'm in my DNS provider settings console, and I will go ahead and create the record which is going to be the CNAME record, and I'm doing it for my account. and the target going to be northernmovers.azureafd.net. And I will go ahead and select save changes here. Now your console may look a little different, but the point is same, that you need to create this entry. Now I will go back in the Azure Front Door and verify this setting. Now if I just refresh the settings and type the custom domain again, you will notice that the CNAME configuration requirement is met and it's no longer giving the warning. With the CNAME entry completed, we're going to turn on the custom domain HTTPS. This is a mandatory step required for Azure AD B2C to work with Azure Front Door. So we select enabled, and the TLS version going to be 1.2. We're going to keep Front Door managed. If you wanted to bring your own certificate, you can do that using keyword by using the option use my own certificate. At this point, we're going to keep Azure Front Door managed. We're going to retain all the defaults and select add. In order for this configuration to persist, I will go ahead and select save. And this will go ahead and save this configuration along with the fact that we're going to go ahead and provision the certificate needed for this custom domain. Now, this is going to take a few minutes, so we're going to wait for this deployment to complete and we'll come back to the remaining steps afterwards. The custom HTTPS configuration provisioning is now complete, as you can see with the message. Go ahead and close it. If I go and select the custom domain, you will notice that the certificate management and all the steps under that are now finished successfully. So this completes the HTTPS related configuration for our custom domain. Now, the final setting that we have to do to finish the custom domain setup on the Azure Front Door side is to update the routing rule. And this is the warning that you also see because of that. So let me select the routing rule. And if I go and expand on the domains, you will see we have the custom domain, but it's not selected. So I will go ahead and select it. And we're only going to allow HTTPS. I will retain all the other settings and select update. And finally, to make all these settings persist, I have to click on the save. This will take a few moments. And once done, we are now finished with our Azure Front Door configuration. Custom domain configuration completed on both Azure AD B2C and Azure Front Door. Let's take a look at how we can easily test this setup. I will show you two different ways to do it. One through the portal and other through the command line. To perform the test through the portal, I will go inside the Azure AD B2C option here, and you can perform this same test with Identity Experience Framework or custom policies and user flows. I will choose user flow in this particular case. I have a simple sign-up, sign-in user flow, and I will select the option run user flow. Now you notice that I have created this application for this test, which basically going to redirect the response to jot.ms. I will go and select run user flow. Now at this point, if you notice in the URL here, there is the default domain, northwindprod.b2clogin.com. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to replace this part with the custom domain that we configured through Azure Front Door. And notice now I do see the user flow here. I will go ahead and try to log in with an user. And now I can see that I got the token in return and the issuer showing me the custom domain instead of the b2clogin.com, which is the default domain. For this test, I'm going to be using a simple command line utility. Get this utility by going to the URL aka.ms/checkb2cdomain. This will take you to the Git repo, and here you can find instructions to set it up. It's really simple. You can use Azure Cloud Shell, which is available with Azure subscription, and that will require you to just simply set up the script by installing the dependencies as mentioned here, and you should be ready to go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and open the Cloud Shell, and then we'll run the script against Azure Front Door and B2C endpoint. I'm logged into my subscription and open up Azure Cloud Shell. I'm going to first show you this utility running in Bash, and then I will show you how to run this in PowerShell. I already set it up. I'm going to go ahead and run it. And it basically takes two parameters. The first parameter is the custom domain, which is basically the custom domain that you configured. And the second one is the policy, which is basically can be user flow or a custom policy. I'm using the same user flow from the previous demo. Now, as you can see, it's basically going to go and check the configuration for the custom domain. It found the mapping. This is the AFD front host. Then it tried to connect to the B2C endpoint, and you can see that all the things actually pass and basically giving us the final message that all the things are configured correctly. Now I switch to PowerShell. I'm going to go and run exactly the same command with the same parameter and see how it goes. And notice it's running and everything is turned out to be working great. So again, this is a cross-platform tool. You can also run it on your machine. After you finished configuring the custom domain, you need to do an update on the client application configuration side. Now, this is important because in the client application configuration, you need to make sure that the authority URL is up to date to point to the custom domain and not the default domain with b2clogin.com. Now, this applies to both Microsoft authentication libraries like MSAL for different platforms, but also for the other client libraries that are third party. Here is an example of MSAL.NET endpoint configuration. The Azure AD B2C host name variable pointing to the login.windows.com, which is the custom domain. Here is the example of configuration file for MSAL.js. And notice that the authority is updated to point to login.windows.com. Here's an example for MSAL configuration for iOS and macOS. And notice that the authority URL variable is pointing to the custom domain instead of the default b2clogin.com. And here is an example of MSAL for Android configuration. Let's take a look into the logging capability related to custom domain on Azure AD B2C side. Azure AD B2C audit log contains relevant information in additional detail section. The first one is the client IP address field. This particular field contains request origin IP address, which is the client IP address, followed by the Azure Front Door IP address. Now remember, the request doesn't directly go to Azure AD B2C. It goes through AFD, and you can see that in this particular field. Next, you have the domain name, which is basically the host name used by the request to connect to Azure AD B2C. On the Azure Front Door side, you can gain access to the key performance metrics using the metrics option under monitoring. This contains various set of performance metrics, including total latency, request response sizes, overall backend health percentage. For more comprehensive logging, you can use Azure Diagnostics logs, which are available through Azure Monitor. Azure Diagnostics contains a plethora of key information related to request response, access to the Azure Front Door instance, etc. Here are a few of the resources that you may find helpful when configuring custom domain for Azure AD B2C using Azure Front Door. To sum up, in this video, we look at the architecture of custom domain and how they're enabled through Azure Front Door. We then walk through the series of steps needed on Azure Front Door side and also on Azure AD B2C side to enable custom domain. We then look into the application configuration needed to make sure the client application functions with the custom domain correctly. We also look at the logging capabilities, both on the Azure AD B2C side and also on the Azure AFD side. And finally, we look at the resources that will help you configure custom domain on Azure AD B2C using Front Door. Thanks for watching this video. I hope this will help you configure custom domain on Azure AD B2C.